Good morning. Grace and peace to you in the name of Christ our Lord, and welcome to worship. We're so glad that you are joining with us. I know that many of you are worshiping at home today, and invite you to share that with us, and we connect with one another. Maybe you want to snap a picture of your worship space, your family worshiping together. We invite you to share that on Facebook. You can post it and make sure that you tag our church, First United Methodist Church, Gastonia. We're so excited for our worship time today. Today is Palm Sunday, the day that we remember Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem and the beginning of Holy Week. As we begin to worship today, I invite you to pray with me. Almighty God, thank you for your Spirit that is with us, that joins us together from places near and far. We pray your blessing on our time together and on all of those who are joining with us. In your holy name we pray. And God's people said, Amen. Now let us sing together.
Hosanna in the highest. I see a generation rising up to take their place. Selfless faith, selfless faith. I see a near revival.
Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
Let's affirm what we believe. I invite you to join me in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
At this time in the worship service, I'd like to ask you to go and get your Bible, if you'd like, and follow along as we read these verses from the Psalms, verses 1 and 2, and 19 through 29. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Save us, we beseech you, O Lord. O Lord, we beseech you, give us success. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light. Bind the festal procession with branches up to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will give thanks to you. You are my God, I will extol you. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever.
Hi kids, it's Miss Christy here, and we've been preparing for Palm Sunday, and so this week some of you cut out palms, watched a little video and made your own palm, but if you didn't, that's okay. You can just grab a towel or a blanket. We're gonna do something fun with these in a little bit, but first we wanna hear our story. Okay, so Palm Sunday is a part of Easter that helps us, you know, remember that Jesus was sent for each of us, and it's about his entry into Jerusalem. So let's get into that story. So Jesus and his disciples were traveling to Jerusalem for the Passover feast. Jesus told two disciples to go get a donkey. He even told them where to find the donkey. And Jesus rode that donkey into Jerusalem. And a big crowd gathered on both sides of the street. And they were waving their palm branches, and they were laying their cloaks out, and they were saying, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest." So now I want you to get your palm that you've made or your towel that you grabbed, and I want you to prepare the way for this king, okay? So we sent in clips earlier this week. Some of your parents sent in clips. And so when those clips come on, I want you to join in this part of worship because God loves to hear us praise his name. And so I want you, once we turn those clips on, to wave your palms, wave your towels, and just prepare the way for Jesus because we are excited that he is our king. And so parents, as they're doing this, I'd love for you to participate or take some pictures of this and tag it on Facebook, and just because we want to show how excited we are about Jesus. So everyone, get your palms and get ready and say, "Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna, Hosanna."
Hosanna, blessed it is he that comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna, Hosanna.
Hosanna now.
Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, name of the King, of the name of the King. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, the King's.
And he comes in the name of Hosanna, Hosanna.
Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. When I was with him, when he rode in town, the crowds gathered round him like a king. Smiling faces joined a sea of branches waving, though they were masquerading in the inn. And my heart rose in my throat when I heard them sing, Hosanna. In the highest, whoa, whoa, whoa. And we went upstairs, broke the bread and drank the wine from the only living vine that we would taste. And I watched them take him up the mountainside, where he was crucified, though innocent. And they mocked him and cursed him with their mouths, and told him to come down if he was God. And my heart broke in my chest when I heard him say, forgive them, it is finished. Oh, still feel the anguish when they pierced him in the side, and how the ground beneath us shook upon the very moment that he died. Whoa. 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 And I was with him when he rode into town, and the crowds gathered round him like a king. The smiling faces joined a sea of branches waving, though they were masquerading in the end. And my heart rose in my throat when I heard them sing, Hosanna, in the highest. Whoa. Whoa.
these days, there are lots of ways that we're being intentional about connecting with one another. We're making lots of phone calls, we're sending cards, we're connecting with each other via social media and technology, and we're even finding ways to worship together with technology. But our greatest gift is prayer. Prayer is a way that we can lift up one another in these days in particular, and prayer is a gift, a way that we can connect with God. I invite you in this time to consider your prayer requests that maybe you want to share with the people that are sitting on the couch with you drinking coffee this morning. Maybe you want to lift them from your hearts to God. You can also share them with the church. We're including the prayer list each week in our e-blast. If you feel comfortable sharing publicly, you can list your prayer requests, joys, or concerns in the comment section on Facebook, or feel free to contact the church office or your pastors. We're available to you. I'll offer a prayer. We'll have a moment of silence first. Let us join our hearts together in prayer. Dear God, we know you are with us in these days, for you are with us always. Your Spirit abides with us and within us, and we lift our hearts to you in prayer this day. Though we are in different places, we are connected in one body, your church. We are connected in Christ Jesus, our Lord and the head of the church. And we know that you abide with us. Hear us, O God, as we lift our prayer requests to you, our joys and our concerns. We know you hear all of them. We pause to think about, God, the gifts you have given us, good and wonderful blessings. And we lift those before you and say thank you, for you are good and gracious and faithful, and you have poured out your love and your mercy upon us. We also, God, take time to offer prayers of intercession for our neighbors, both nearby and around the world, who are struggling this day. We lift to you our neighbors who are sick in mind, body, and spirit. We lift to you our neighbors who are serving on the front lines, those who are offering themselves sacrificially. We lift to you our neighbors who are lonely, who are anxious, and who are afraid. We pray, God, that your Spirit of comfort and peace will enter all places, that you will bring about healing and wholeness and comfort to your children. We ask, God, that you would continue to shape us as your disciples. Set us on the path, strengthen our faith, and help us to seek after your will, to shine your light and love in these days. We trust, God, that in the end it is you who has the final word, and our faith, our love, our life are all in you. And now we join our voices together as one in the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
It's good to be with you today, and I just want to remind you that you will please continue to do the giving that you've been doing. And if I can just remind you about that today, that you can do that. You can, you know, you can send it to the church. You know how to get hold of the way to mail it in if you like to, or to still do draft. So, but we just want to remind you that we still need to do what we need. And so we appreciate your help in doing that. And that moves us into the scripture for today, which is the 21st chapter of Matthew 1 through 11. When they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethpage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Untie them, bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say, the Lord needs them, and he will send them immediately. This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, Tell the daughter of Zion, look, Your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey, and on a colt, the foal of a donkey. The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and that followed him were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven." When he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." Thanks be to God for the gospel that we share together today.
Let's pray together. Most holy God, inform this time, speak through the words of my mouth and the thoughts and meditations of all of our hearts, so that what you desire may be accomplished. In the name of Christ we pray, amen. Today I want us to think about expectations a little bit. Expectations that we have of God. And I want to start out by telling you a story about growing up in North Wilkesboro. I grew up in the parsonage across the street from the church you see on your screen. Beautiful church, beautiful town, a great place to grow up. And I, as you know, because I've told you many times, I was the youngest of four children, and all the other kids were pretty, a good amount older than me. When I was about 8 years old, my oldest brother, Mark, had his driver's license. So that meant that I could ride his bike, and he had a five-speed Schwinn bike that had one of those things on the back you could lean up against, and I had a no-speed bike. So to me, it was a matter of justice that I got to ride his bike. He never wanted me to, but I did. So one day I took his bike out up on the top of E Street in between the parsonage and the church, and I was going to ride down the hill. And since I was already playing with fire, riding a bike I wasn't supposed to ride, I thought, I'm going to say a word that I'm not supposed to say that I had picked up down at the Little League ballpark from the parents. Let that sink in. Not the kids, the parents of old people watching little people play a game, cussing us out. So there was one particular word I thought, I'm going to see what it feels like to say it. I got at the top of E Street and I started down and I geared up to fifth gear. I was going as fast as I could, at least like 6 miles an hour. And I said the word out loud and bam, right into the only telephone pole on that sidewalk. Now, it did keep me from cussing for a few years. I was sure that God threw me into that pole. But I tell you that story because I got so engrossed with one thing, just seeing what it would feel like to say that word, that I forgot the most basic thing, to watch where I was going. You see, I believe that's what's happening in our scripture for today, for Palm Sunday. I saw something in this reading that Jim shared with us earlier that I've never seen before, or at least never paid attention to. The scripture says the people shout, "Hosanna to the Son of David." Hosanna, which literally means save us now. And then when they get into the city, the whole city in verse 10 asks, "Who is this? Who is this?" They've been shouting, "Save us now." And then they say, "Who is this?" And their response is, "He's the prophet." Well, friends, prophets just speak. Hosanna was a word originally that meant save us now, but it had become just a yay, just a way of shouting. They were so engrossed with Hosanna, so engrossed with the yay, that they missed the most basic thing, salvation being offered to them. You see, by the time of Jesus' entry, Hosanna had been lessened to just a word people said when they were excited. The meaning had changed. It's like many words in our language. You see the slide now about the word awful, how awful used to mean reverent, but now it means unpleasant. You can think of many words that are like that. Love is one. We love everything, don't we? But love is something that is very specific. Love is meant to mean Jesus. Sadly, we have lowered our expectations and we miss God's results. And then something like this coronavirus emerges and we struggle because we want results. Let's change the expectation back to save us now. What they went through in that first Holy Week is a reminder of how badly we need to raise our expectations to match with God's results. Friends, our faith isn't meant to be a feel-good party. This is a salvation experience. I remember crying to my mama as a kid because the kids on the bus that I rode called me Fat Harold the Zit-Faced Boy. I've told you that many times. It really hurt me, and I would run home, and my sweet mama would just take me in her lap and rub my greasy hair and say, "Honey, they're just jealous." I'm not sure what they were jealous of, but somehow she made me feel better. But listen, it didn't change me. She just made me feel better. It's sort of like the mother of James and John in chapter 20. And if you have your Bibles with you, I hope you'll read through that. Just before Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem in Matthew 21, the mother of James and John comes to Jesus and says, "Hey, I want you to do a favor for my boys. Make them feel good. Let them sit on the right and on the left. Let them be the closest to you. Please, Jesus, keep them in the AIG class." Well, you see, she was just doing what mamas do, looking out for their children. But as a 53-year-old, I can tell you the best thing that my mama did was not to stroke my hair. The best thing my mama did was to point me to Jesus Christ, who offers salvation. Friends, we cannot lower our expectations of God to just make us feel better. Our faith, our Savior, is worth so much more than that. God's results in Jesus Christ are salvation. The ship is safe in the harbor. But that's not what it's created for. It's created to go out and to sail. We were created to live our lives even through pandemics, even in difficulty. We were not created just to be stroked. We were created to live in the salvation that Jesus offers. Listen, I get that we all want to feel better right now. I've talked with people this week on the telephone who have spoken the words I've been thinking. I just miss getting to see my church family. I just miss getting to hug folks, getting to shake hands, getting to laugh with people. But listen, we cannot lower our expectations of God's results anywhere below salvation. To save now for all of us. Earlier in our service, we said the Apostles' Creed, which is a reminder that is why we are here. We believe in a God who made himself incarnate, who came to earth to offer you and me salvation. Over this time of being quarantined, our church has been active through staff and laity, we've taken food to homes. We have had backpack pickups through our parking lots. We've given funds. We've done lots of things. And we do not do those things because we are nice. We do those things because God has offered us salvation in Jesus Christ. We must not lower our expectations of God's results. It's not easy. We face difficulty spiritually this week as we go through Holy Week. We face difficulty in a very real way physically this week with this coronavirus all around us. But God is with us. As the psalmist says in our psalm for today, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. Don't lower expectations to just feel good in the moment. God's love is forever. Those are God's results. Not Hosanna, yay, but Hosanna, save us now. Do our expectations match God's results? Don't forget the most basic thing, that Jesus Christ came to save us. Hosanna indeed. Let's pray. God, thank you for your promise of life with us. Forgive us when we lower our expectations of your results. Forgive us. Help us to match our expectations to your matchless results. You have come to save us. Even as we go through the difficulty of this week, please, God, guide us. And remind us of your promise. Hosanna. In the name of Christ we pray. Amen.
You are good, you are good, when there's nothing good in me. You are love. Play for all to see. You are light when the darkness closes in. You are hope, you have covered all my sin. You are peace when my fear is crippling. You are truth, even in my sing, no. name, Jesus, Jesus. My heart will sing, no other name, Jesus, Jesus. My heart will sing, no other name, Jesus, Jesus.
Hey everybody, thank you for worshiping with us today. I want to leave you with this thought and this blessing, not original. The best good news is that God loves us and there's nothing we can do about it, but we get to leave here and leave these pews empty so we can do something with it in the world. Go forth in God's grace. Amen.